Next on WCW Pro Wrestling, the diabolical Kevin Sullivan in singles competition, plus comments from the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair concerning Hulk Hogan, and the natural Dustin Rhodes will also be in action. And Lord Stephen Regal puts his World Television title on the line in a rematch against the challenge of Brad Armstrong. WCW Pro Wrestling is next.
Well, hi, everybody, and welcome once again to WCW Pro Wrestling on a Saturday morning. I'm Gordon Solie, alongside the living legend Larry Zbyszko and the American Dream himself, Dusty Rhodes. We're going to see Dusty's son, Dustin Rhodes, in action in just a moment. But before that, we're going to hear a response from Ric Flair to comments made by Hulk Hogan last week.
Yeah, that's going to be real interesting, you know, because in your life there's always somebody you want to say something to. Personally, I'd like to tell Ed McMahon, quit sending me the order forms. Just send me the $10 million, Ed.
Yeah, well, keep on waiting. Don't hold your breath. Now then, Dusty, main event, Lord Stephen Regal, now defending his title, as you said last week.
We're getting all across the country this morning. We are seeing the best today because something got to happen with Brad Armstrong and Lord Stephen Regal. Big main event, World TV title on the line. One fall, 20 minutes, and down in Amarillo, they're just getting up right now, but they got an old saying down there. Brad, you better cowboy up because it's going to be a long, hard ride today on the Pro. And whoa, let's do it. Hi, darling, I'm back.
All right, we're also going to tonight on WCW Saturday Night. We'll be hearing more comments from Hulk Hogan. But right now, let's go to these comments from the WCW champion, Ric Flair.
I think since you, a close friend of mine, have the audacity week after week, Gene, to refer to Hulk Hogan, a great movie star, a guy who's got his own series, as the immortal Hulk Hogan, in my presence, knowing that Ric Flair, knowing it very well, is the only 11-time World Heavyweight Champion, then it would be in my best interest to say to you, Gene, go back to Orlando, get Bobby Heenan, get Hogan in a very close, secure area, and ask Hulk one more time just exactly what his intentions are and just exactly what he sees as a future in WCW.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, December 1 ball, introducing first, from Austin, Texas, at 261 pounds, the natural, Dustin Rhodes!
And he'll be going up against Otis Apollo in this one ball event. And he'll be making those introductions momentarily. Tonight, of course, Hulk Hogan will respond to those comments from Ric Flair.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Windsor, Ontario, Canada, at 225 pounds, Otis Apollo!
Otis Apollo facing the natural Dustin Rhodes. Dusty, I imagine your heart has to quicken every time you see your son in the ring.
What a rush, I'm telling you. Every time I see, watch out, old Otis here, jumping on Dustin Rhodes. Every time I see the natural walk into the square circle, me, my mama, everybody around the country gets excited about this because 1990, major title for Dustin Rhodes.
His blood's thicker than water.
Blood is thicker than water in this booth today, bro.
Ah, Dustin Rhodes got a beautiful elbow on the top of the skull that has Otis shaking his head a bit. And now a series of chopping left hands to the side of the jaw. Irish whip into the ropes. Caught him with a double sledge.
Oh, he has a boogie-woogie and a good shot of rhythm and blues right there.
I don't know if the boogie-woogie counts for anything, but one thing about Dusty, he's a big guy. He can reach out and tag you. And for a guy, what, 260, 270, can move like a lightweight.
261 pounds, actual weight, beautiful high. Vertical souple by the natural Dustin Rhodes has Otis Apollo back to the canvas once again. Slashing blow to the side of the temple. And Otis Apollo, I'm sure right now, is beginning to wish that he was anywhere except into the ring. Hip lock takedown by the natural.
You know, Dustin Rhodes has trained all his life for events like this. And the excitement that's generated by me just looking at him right here today, I'm telling you, 1990, major title for Dustin, the natural Rhodes, gotten so late.
This is 1994.
I said the 90s, Larry, oh, the 90s, brother.
Almost half over.
Well, a bit of a technicality there, but nonetheless, a side headlock now by the natural Dustin Rhodes on Otis Apollo. Apollo manages to get him back in the corner. Knee lifts that were not especially effective. Dustin Rhodes comes off, ducks to one side. Apollo tried to fire in there, brother. He found out that was...
Brad, take him home with the dog, baby. Take him home.
There's the Bulldog. And he hooks the near leg. Count of three, it's all over. Well, Buckhouse Buck has got his eye on Dustin Rhodes, that's for sure. But Dustin looking fine as usual when he steps inside that square circle.
I tell you, take a look at Dustin Rhodes here. He hooked Apollo with the Bulldog. Big man, and he can drive that head down. Bam!
Oh, 6'6" of him. Throw him back to the canvas. I'll tell you what, we're going to take a brief commercial timeout, and we're going to be hearing from Mean Gene Okerlund.
The thunder of hoofbeats, the swirling clouds of dust, a whole bunch of double tough hombres looking for trouble and ready for action. The brand, WCW. The showdown, Spring Stampede. Sunday, April 17th, 7 p.m. Eastern. Live and only on pay-per-view. Call your local cable operator for availability.
All right, fans, joining me at this time, Kevin Sullivan and his brother, the Equalizer. Oh, I beg your pardon. Should I say Dave Sullivan? Eban. You know, the doctors can fix this guy. They can treat dyslexia.
Well, let me tell you something. This is a Sullivan problem, Oakland, if there is a problem. And I don't see your name being Sullivan. There's nothing wrong with Dave. He's a special...
Eban. It's Eban.
And you say there's nothing wrong with him? This guy's a little off.
The reason why he may be off is people abused him during different times. And the person that abused him was the person I sent him to, who left him out in the cold in WCW. I haven't forgotten about that, Mac.
You care to divulge who this individual is?
Not right now. What we have to get at is the Nasty Boys. And I'm going to tell you a little story. I used to take my brother down to the junkyard.
To the junkyard, man. Yeah, tell him. Tell him, brother.
And you know what we used to do, Gene? We used to get big sticks, and we used to hunt those nasty little rats.
Rats, yeah.
Until we got them cornered. And when we got those rats cornered,
tell them what
we used to take those clubs and make them squeal.
Yeah.
Nasty Boys. You're looking at the most nasty family of all. You see, there's a fine line between men and boys.
We're men. Men.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. What can you say?
Promotional considerations paid for by the following.
New Jurassic Park dinosaurs are on the loose. Can the Dino Tracker stop them? T-Rex Turner breaks up a fight. Jaws, Jackson, Snags, or Ramhead. Look for all the incredible action. It lives on Jurassic Park.
Jim. Jim.
For everything that squeaks, now there's one lube, and everyone should like the sound of that. One lube from Slick 50.
The bell, and Sullivan wasted no time.
You know what, God, there's a mean streak that running Kevin Sullivan as long as the Nile River. I mean, he ain't gonna change his way. Got his brother with him now. I mean, it's I don't know, I'm anxious to see what kind of package we get out of this.
Beautiful gut-wrench soldier by Kevin Sullivan that time. And don't ever forget that the Sullivan, of course, was an amateur state champion in Massachusetts.
Well, he knows the moves, Sullivan, no question about it, but He does definitely have a vicious instinct. We see an example of it right here. Kevin Sullivan, what is he doing?
Wow. I think he felt that his brother wasn't paying enough attention to the match. Being the older brother, he ruled with an iron hand all the time the kid was growing up, I understand.
During the match, you never talk to the women at ringside.
You never do?
I certainly do not.
I think it was just an attitude adjustment on Mr. Kevin's part right there. You see, he's taking the win and the sail that, oh, he's scratching him in the back.
Love your nails.
Kevin Sullivan wasting no time inflicting any kind of punishment he can on Sonny Rogers. Rogers, no stranger to the squared circle, but he's got his hands full now.
I tell you, wrestling Kevin Sullivan's enough to make you a stranger to the squared circle, especially allowing how much time he's going to need to heal up here.
You know, you talk about strangers to the squared circle. Well, tonight we're going to hear from no stranger at all. We're talking about the Hulkster himself, Mr. Hulk Hogan tonight. We're going to talk about the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Yeah, I'd be real curious to hear his comments. I'm sure going to be checking out Tony Schiavone and Bobby the Brain Heenan and that interview, of course, coming up. Sullivan.
Look at Sullivan here. I mean, he knows the moves. He knows how to apply the pressure properly. He knows how to make his opponent wither in pain. Whether he chooses to do it or just beat somebody into oblivion is a matter of his choice.
He learned this thing right here, the nerve hold, from a Buddha Dean over in Asia way
Buddha
back.
Buddha monk?
A Buddha Dean. He went over there to Asia. God and soul, they know the whole story about Buddha Dean and the Tree of Woe and the one-eyed monster. Yeah. I mean, Kevin Sullivan knows all the nerve parts that he learned over in Asia.
Brings his man back into the corner now. Still has the arm Sullivan barred, and there's a hard ripping smash into the side of the jaw by Kevin Sullivan. Now goes into a snapmare to the canvas once again. And, oh, David issuing comments from outside, and I thought Sullivan was going to go for the knee until he heard it from David. Then he went with a flat of the foot.
Well, this is a dangerous place for this young man to be out here, because there are two of them out there. The brothers, they are. You talk about blood thick and water a while ago. I don't know if it's the same case right here.
Rogers being jammed into the steel ring post. Smashed to the outside canvas once again.
Well, blood may be thicker than water, but then again, water doesn't turn into a scab.
I don't think I'll even pursue that one, Larry. Rogers now having his problems trying to get back up into the ring.
Oh, what a blow to the back of the head right there.
Sullivan built like a Sherman tank.
Yeah, look at the size of the legs on Sullivan. It looks like a Tyrannosaurus Rex without the tail.
Shades of Johnny Valentine. That massive forearm across the chest while his man is spread eagle on the ropes.
You know, if I had one of them teleprompter teledeals like John Madden had, I would draw a big X on this opponent right here, because I think this ball game is all over. You know what I mean? I think it's in the it's ready to go to the dugout.
Yeah, it's not a question of whether or not, it's just when. Irish whip off the ropes, caught him coming in.
Ooh!
250 pounds down across those abdominis erecti muscles.
It's over, baby.
And David's very happy for him.
Oh, look at that. Brotherly love.
Selling affection.
How sweet.
Well, you've got an interesting situation between these two, and obviously David has looked up to Kevin all of his life.
Well, right here you see this, like you said, 255 pounds coming right down on your stomach, blows the wind out of you. Kevin don't even need to hook a leg. Goes down, ask him about his mama, and it's all over. One, two, three.
Well, some quick comments, and then we're going to have our Spring Stampede Control Center.
On WCW Main Event, the grounds are shaking, the earth's a-quaking, when the Boss and Ron Simmons collide. Tomorrow night, 6:05 Eastern on TBS.
What happened to the lights?
It's just a power outage, Dad.
What was that?
It's just Bart eating a Butterfinger.
Ooh, and a
It sounds like he's right over.
Here!
Oh, how about a bite, little buddy?
Well, okay, just one.
Hey, this tastes just like a dog biscuit!
Get a crispity, crunchity, peanut buttery burst in every bite of Butterfinger.
Nobody better lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
America's favorite team has returned.
Look at the lineup we have coming back. Rick Wild Thing Vaughn. Catcher and team leader Jake Taylor. Veteran third baseman Roger Dorr. Also back is Willie Mays Hayes. And he's out by an eyelash at third. Boy, we never seem to get the close ones.
Major League 2, rated PG. Starts Wednesday, March 30th at a theater near you.
Hi, folks. I'm Gene Okerlund in the Spring Stampede Control Center. Hey, we're just 3 weeks away from Chicago. Live on pay-per-view, Sunday, April 17th at 7 o'clock Eastern Time. Two more blockbuster matches have just been added to an already powerful lineup. The international title holder, Ravishing Rick Rude, feels he was duped into a defense of his coveted title belt. In the meantime, the challenger Sting isn't denied anything. And after all, he does have the match that he'd so desperately wanted. Also just inked by WCW officials, World Television Champion, the pompous Lord Steven Regal, will be defending against the veritable buzzsaw in Flyin' Brian Pillman. Speaking of Flyin' Brian, he and Sting team up this weekend to battle Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff and his partner Paul Roma elsewhere here at World Championship Wrestling. Now then, at the Spring Stampede of the main event, WCW heavyweight champ, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair, defends against Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Now, I trust that Flair is focused on Steamboat. If he's not, he could be in deep trouble in Chicago. Hang on to your hats. Here's the first. Not of the Windy City, certainly, but here at World Championship Wrestling. The Nasty Boys square off against Cactus Jack and Max Payne in a no-rules Chicago street fight. Anything goes, and balls count anywhere. Hey, I wouldn't even venture a guess on what's going to happen in the much-talked-about grudge match between 320 pounds of the Boss and his opponent, the big 452-pound monster known as Vader. After what happened at Super Brawl, this could be all-out war. A match that will have the eyes of the world on it. United States heavyweight champion, stunning Steve Austin, meets the great Muta from Japan. And again, if you can't join us in Chicago, do the next best thing. Join us live on pay-per-view cable TV, or for you folks with satellite dishes, call Turner Home Satellite at 1-800-847-3229. Sunday, April 17th, 7 o'clock Eastern Time, 6 in Chicago. Don't miss the Spring Stampede. Hey, this weekend, on my exclusive hotline report, I'm going to be bringing you up to date on the exciting, young, fresh, daring, dynamic, and tremendously talented tag team of Too Cold Scorpio and Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Find out why they're the hottest tag team going in WCW. Give me a call at 1-900-909-9900. Kids, you need your parents' permission.
Time now for our WCW flashback here on WCW Pro on a Saturday morning. Ricky the Dragon against Paul Orndorff, Larry.
Yeah, it was a classic matchup. Watch Ricky the Dragon. You better be careful with these autographs. Look what happened to Rick Rude. Steamboat, though, he's got a classical matchup coming up at the Spring Stampede.
Yeah, the World Heavyweight Championship goes on the line.
Whoa, let me tell you about that Spring Stampede. You know, signing autographs, being on the pro show, talking about the Spring Stampede, talking about flashbacks, is all part of the excitement going on here with God and Sonny Lazarbisco. I'm going to take Ricky Steamboat on his last ride. I'm going to say it's going to be all out after the Spring Stampede. I say he's all sharp. Let's go to the
All right, time to see Ricky the Dragon and Paul Orndorff at Daytona Beach Clash of Champions.
Well, Jess, I tell you, a lot has gone on here at Clash of the Champions. A lot still to come.
Yeah, I see you shaking your head.
Or actually nodding your head. And you know,
Johnny B. Badd announced to you that this Saturday he will unmask. We know that Ric Flair and Sting will collide for the NWA title this Saturday on TBS on WCW Saturday Night.
Absolutely, and that's regardless of what happens tonight.
That's right. They will be tag team partners later on, but they will be against each other for the NWA title. Sting and Ric Flair this Saturday, 6:05 Eastern Time, live here on TBS. Head first goes Steamboat. Tremendous move by Orndorff.
Whoa, and again, Orndorff within an eyelash two times of getting that three count. Come on, Tony, admit it. How aggressive Mr. Wonderful's wrestling tonight.
Mr. Orndorff, or Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, really on top of his game. On the outside now goes Steamboat. Down to the floor, and the Dragon is in major trouble here.
The Dragon's Dragon.
So to speak, yes. And Orndorff working on the back. You still maybe can hear the chant of Paula. Many of the fans have not let up on Orndorff.
Whoa! Steamboat dropped to a knee, and Orndorff with his momentum went head first into the buckle.
No, sir, got a two count. And that was close, Jess.
Big chop by the Dragon.
A two count. Side of the head goes Steamboat. Elevates Orndorff. The Dragon puts him down with a back suplex.
Oh, but he cracked his own head on the mat.
Sure did. Maybe he had a cover there, but waited a little bit too long, and now Orndorff's out in two.
That's an important thing. When you do a suplex like move like that, you've got to ensure you've tucked your chin. Otherwise, your head could hit the canvas, as the case of Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Now he's chopping away on Mr. Wonderful. You know what I've noticed? There hasn't been one fist thrown in this bout yet, Tony.
Double chop.
Oh, now come on. That's very questionable right there. Steamboat hit Orndorff and drove him over the top rope. Is that not a disqualification?
It's the momentum of the chop, not the intentional throw. Steamboat! Boy, you're talking about taking a risk. Steamboat went flying on the outside. Right in the feet of our ring announcers, Gary Capetta and Michael Buffer. Orndorff hit hard on the outside. Steamboat turned his back that time, getting the referee out of the way. And he's paying for it here, Jeff.
Wonderful with a cover.
And Steamboat gets out of it. Once again, the pinning combination, but he's out of it again. One, two, he's on the ropes, and that'll stop the count. Orndorff's going with the... Don't, Jess, don't hand him that belt.
Oh!
He hasn't won it. One, two!
Whoa!
Steamboat got a two count. The belt is in the ring, as you can see. Orndorff going for the pile driver. Steamboat. One, two! Now Orndorff, one, two!
No!
Oh, great bridge up by Orndorff.
Tremendous bridge by Mr. Wonderful. But Steamboat right into a backslide.
One, two!
No!
Oh, so close! And again, Steamboat, he goes down. Steamboat and I lash away from being the world television champion. The big foot.
And Wonderful, Mr. Wonderful walked into that one. Here goes Steamboat up to the top, the Dragon! Hits it, big crossbody. Reversal by Wonderful.
Oh, Steamboat got away. Ricky Steamboat, the Dragon. Rolls up Orndorff, two.
He got him.
We've got a new champion.
This is unbelievable.
In the May WCW magazine, get inside the brain of Bobby Heenan. Find out who wants Ric Flair's belt. And Too Cold Scorpio and Marcus Bagwell get the third degree.
How did they find that out?
the WCW Magazine. Get your copy now. Available on newsstands everywhere.
Well, our main event is upcoming right now, a world championship match. Lord Steven Regal defending that title against the challenger, Brad Armstrong. And just 2 weeks ago, Dust, you said this would happen.
Well, 2 weeks ago, you know, Laz Zabisco brought it to the Dream's attention that Brad Armstrong busted Lord Steven Regal in the noggin, knocked him out colder than a wedge, left him laying for dead right there on the floor. The pro show is very excited today about the return match that I did call, legend, that I did call. He got a shot today. Brad against Lord Steven Regal.
Yeah, good calling, American Dream. You know, it's going to be an exciting matchup for Brad Armstrong, and I noticed by your jacket, you're into the cowboy bit. You'll like this. You know, Wyatt Earp said that fast is fine, accuracy is final. Brad Armstrong, he's fast, Gordon, but Lord Steven Regal is accurate.
Well, we're going to find out, but first, let's go back just 2 weeks and see the situation that occurred between Brad Armstrong and Lord Steven Regal, and then we'll have our title match.
His lordship on the canvas, and his lordship is backing away. Oh. There again, his lordship was one step ahead.
That's why these guys were sticking to the basics earlier, because they're both good enough to capitalize on mistakes. You don't want to run in. Hey, he just nailed him with the cast.
Oh, no, he got him with his forearm. That's all it was.
But his cast is on the forearm.
That's way down on the wrist. Take a look at it. He's counted him out.
Really hit him with the cast.
Promotional considerations paid for by the following.
Machine Gun Blasting, Molten Morphing, Terminator 2 video game action, in T2 the arcade game, and Terminator 2 Judgment Day. Now on Super NES, Genesis, and Game Gear.
Hot Pockets!
Hot Pockets, filled with pepperoni pizza or ham and cheese in a crispy pocket.
What are you gonna pick?
Try Lean Pockets, too.
Introducing Castlevania Bloodlines for Sega Genesis, the most horrifying vampire hunt ever. Two new heroes, plus hordes of evil enemies and ghastly ghouls. It's intense adventure from Konami.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following main event contest is for the World Television Championship, set for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first the challenger from Marietta, Georgia. He weighs 236 pounds.
Great opportunity for Brad Armstrong. He won that right when he defeated Lord Steven Regal recently. And I tell you what, I'm really curious to know what Hulk Hogan's got to say about Ric Flair tonight on WCW Saturday Night, along with Tony Schiavone and Bobby the Brain Heenan. Should be some interesting comments indeed. That's tonight, WCW Saturday Night with Hulk Hogan. Right now, let's go back to our ring announcer.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent. From the Tower of Blackpool, he weighs 18 stones, 2 pounds, and he's the World Television Champion, Lord Steven Regal!
Well, Larry, he's taking his own sweet time about getting out there.
Well, obviously, Lord Regal, you know, I think is in complete control of this situation, Gordon. He doesn't want to be hassled by these peasants, and as far as he's concerned, wrestling Brad Armstrong is just another plate of fish and chips.
Well, I'll tell you what, I think it's going to be a little more than fish and chips. Talking to the commissioner, Nick Bockwinkel, prior to this occasion right here, a lot of people said cast was used to get this return match. Whatever was used is, Brad Armstrong has an opportunity tonight with a cast, without a cast, with whatever he's got to take the World Television title from Mr. Lord Steven Regal.
Fantastic opportunity indeed, and certainly a young man that's totally deserving. You know, taking a look at Regal now, compared to the referee and compared to Brad Armstrong, he claims 18 stone, 2 pounds. Translated, that's 254 pounds. He looks a little heavier than that to me, Dust.
Well, I think that no matter where you cut it, he is in top tip shape, and Laz Zabisco can testify. I know this man's training. I mean, he's a World Television Champion. No means, we talk a lot about him making the time. We talk about him being on the defense. We talk about the other guy have to be very offensive. But in this case here, I'm sure Lord Steven Regal wants a victory over Brad Armstrong.
Well, I'm sure he does, Larry.
Well, give or take a stone, it's not that big of a deal. On the mat, on his feet, Lord Steven Regal, great mat technician. And that's what's important.
Look at those forearms right off the bat by Lord Stephen Wrigley wasted no time in trying to soften up Brad Armstrong. Armstrong reverses the Irish whip, gets us a move, beautiful. Flying drop kick, moves in on his man, a full scoop slam on Lord Stephen Wrigley. Cross body right, too soon to try for a pinfall.
Yeah, but he could be trying to psych Lord Wrigley out. Look at Armstrong here, look at the offensive onslaught. Brad Armstrong, he's got the right strategy too for Lord Wrigley. He's got to be on the offense, he's got to be aggressive, he's got to keep things going. Of course, Lord Wrigley thinking he exited stage left.
Well, time is on his side, there's no question about that. He's got an ally in the clock. The referee warning Brad Armstrong to move back. Wrigley trying to break the momentum of Brad Armstrong.
Yeah, Great Britain, they're always looking for an ally.
Well, I know you don't get along too well with Regal.
Well, he's starting to get under my skin. I mean, I don't care what his opinions are, but don't make any personal shots against me.
Look here, guys, right here. You know, I watched from the onslaught while you guys were talking right here that Lord Regal went at this thing a little bit different than he did the last prior match. He went at it more aggressive, and right then he just started to try to get an arm hold, try to go to work on that cast. And if it were me, I would already be stoving that cast until powder come out of it.
Yeah, he's going to move toward the weak point. Any professional athlete will do that. Football, baseball, boxing, you name it. If there's an area of the anatomy that might be the weakest, that's the point you go for. And that's exactly what Regal looked like he was doing. And again, like you said, Dusty's back under that left arm and left wrist.
Yeah, but we already realize that Brad Armstrong has the integrity of Tonya Harding. I mean, Armstrong already nailed Lord Regal with the cast before. Why should Regal go in, try to work on the cast, and get pounded in the head again?
Well, that's the risk he'll have to take. There's certainly no,
but he's not taking it. Look at Gordon. He's staying outside, locking up with the hands. I think he's trying to stay away from that cast.
Well, to answer that, Larry, if a man come at me with a hammer, I'm going to try to take the ball peen hammer away from him before he hits me with it. You understand what I'm saying?
There he is, concentrating on the hand and the cast on Brad Armstrong. And you can see Armstrong now grimacing in pain, and he fought to get away from that. So he's got his own set of problems now. And I think Armstrong realizes that that cast may have played a part in his getting this world title match, but now it may serve to his detriment.
Well, the one thing that Brad Armstrong won't be able to do with that hand, I don't think, is really lock his hands together. And of course, that's a big part of wrestling, whether you're cradling somebody up, trying to hook them, you've got to have a grip.
Open slap that time by Regal, right on the cast, and Armstrong is backing off. Armstrong backing off, and now obviously protecting that left arm.
You know, God, we talk about breaking a man's body down a lot of times. We talk about grabbing a headlock on arm or leg. If you break a certain part of a man's body down, then you go break him down. Well, I think right here, the whole left side of Brad Armstrong becomes very vulnerable if I was the world television champion. That's what I'd be doing. But we are mistaken if we think for 1 second that Brad Armstrong is not a fiery competitor and a top contender for the world television title.
No question about that. And now that bowler-like forearm, another one by Lord Stephen Regal, has Brad Armstrong shaken. Snapmare takes him to the canvas, and once again Regal goes after that left arm of Brad Armstrong. He's using the whole arm as a target. There's the bat of the foot. And that's all within the rules, too.
A couple of busted fingers there.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's keeping him tied up now. Interesting formation of an arm bar here. Pressure on the cast and also pressure on the deltoids.
There's some pressure on the shoulder right there. Lower the center of gravity on top of the Brad Armstrong shoulder. Here, back to the hammerlock. Going to dig the elbow and right to the bridge of the nose and the eyes. All the little tricks of the trade are coming out here.
Keeping that hammerlock tied on him. Lord Stephen Regal now certainly a long way from a potential victory, but right now things very definitely going his way, Dusty.
Control of the situation is what's taking place right here. The left side of Brad Armstrong's being worked on. I don't care if it's his toe, his foot, his heel. When you got an injury like his hand right here, now watch this. Stomping on the arm, brother, that's pain, blues, and agony for Brad Armstrong.
Yeah, and Lord Regal, he can tie Armstrong up as much as he wants. The clock is on his side. Armstrong's the one who's going to have to be aggressive and go after Regal.
Yeah, and you really can't be aggressive with your back to the man trying to walk away from him. And that's exactly what Armstrong's being forced to do right now. Caught from behind, chin lock, and arm barred, and let's see what Armstrong, well, again, there's that concentration and that punishment to the left arm of one Brad Armstrong. Or Sir William marching around outside, very pleased with himself and with his man.
Brilliant game plan. I mean, he set from the own slot to go to work on the hand, to go to work on the left side of the body, continued to do so. Lord Steven Regal is definitely in charge of this World TV title match right here.
Oh, yeah, great game of human chess going on. And Red Armstrong's a great player, but being injured is one thing, but being injured against Lord Regal's another.
Cheap shot that time on Brad Armstrong. Lots of pain in Armstrong's entire left side of his body, but that was definitely a cheap shot. Now here's Regal back once again. Sort of a chicken wing on that arm, that bottom wrist lock, if you will. Brings it up behind the man's head.
Well, he's got it from a different angle. Here in the top wrist lock into this arm bar. Again, the left side of Brad Armstrong slowly being deteriorated away. Strength being gone, nerve endings being severed. Numbness taking over the entire body. And Lord Regal is well on top of the situation.
You know, God, and Brad Armstrong needs to try to mount some type of offense. I know that's hard to talk about at this point in juncture in this World Television title match, but it's like a one-armed man fighting in a big battle here, a street fight. He's got to fight back somehow. Every blow he takes, every piece of the left side of his body is in a tremendous amount of pain. I tell you, I don't know how he's going to get out of this.
I tell you, I was in Vegas and I got beat to death by the one-armed bandits.
Yeah, that's a slightly different sport. Lord Regal now not paying any attention to Sir William, as Regal, I think, is really closed in now with that wrist lock. He's got Brad Armstrong tied up, and Armstrong in serious trouble here. Referee watching it very, very carefully now. Nick Patrick checking to see if Brad Armstrong's about to concede, but I don't think the word concede is in the vocabulary of Brad.
No, it's not. You know, the ironic part here, interesting, that cast on the left hand of Armstrong is almost a better handle to grab onto because it can't sweat.
Right.
So Regal can get a better grip on that than slipping off of someone's arm full of sweat.
Cool, there you go. Now we need to mount some offense right here. You got a good hand, you got a good arm right there. Good forearm to the head. Brad's got to really come back on this thing right here.
Good shoulder smash, but he came off on the left side and once again re-injured himself, overhooks the man's head, tried to go for a high suit play, but Lord Steven Regal outboxed him that time, back down with a hammerlock now on Brad Armstrong, keeping him on the mat.
You know, and I see a sad situation here forming for Brad Armstrong. I think he's trying to grab at straws. He sees an opening, but he rushes into it like we just saw. Trying to suplex Regal, but Regal saw it coming, felt it coming. And here's Brad Armstrong once again paying that piper.
Well, Larry, let me tell you something. I think that Lord Steven Regal needs to realize one thing. Even though he is in full control right now, there's something else inside an Armstrong. It's an intestinal fortitude that the Armstrong family has. Right here is an opportunity to win the World Television Champion. He's in a lot of pain, but believe me, he's not going to go out without a fight.
Well, you know, I mean,
amen to that.
That's almost like saying this guy's able to lose with dignity and honor, but it doesn't mean nothing to me.
Oh, there you go. Beautiful counter there by Brad Armstrong, but Lord Steven Regal down in the far corner.
10 minutes remain.
And according to that, there's only 10 minutes remaining in this match. This match, of course, one fall 20. High knee lift by Brad Armstrong as Lord Steven Regal double over and aim catches him on the looping right hand in the midsection. Then a snapmare that takes him to the canvas. Crashes down with the elbow, but again went to that left side. That was a mistake, and Regal rolled away from it.
There's no need to do that. That was a bad mistake on that. Well, it might have been just instinct by Brad Armstrong, the instinct of using that elbow, of using that side. But right here, Lord Steven Regal once again goes back in, takes a hook on it, got him down, and time is now really on the side of Lord Steven Regal.
Yeah, you know, interesting here. You know, when you have a rat cornered, the little animal goes berserk out of fear. And I think that's what we have here with Brad Armstrong. He sees an opening, tries to rush in out of desperation, but you can't make emotional mistakes against Bart Regal. He's got to move.
High backdrop now by Brad Armstrong. Had Regal back to the canvas. But look at the way Regal broke down the knee and took Brad Armstrong to the canvas. Now it's Armstrong on top of Regal, cocking that right hand, and then thinks better of it, smashes Regal into the turnbuckle. Regal has been staggered. Armstrong pulses in, smashes him into another turnbuckle, head first. And it's Regal now, Irish whip into the far turnbuckle, caught Armstrong coming in, a knee into the chest. I was talking to Billy Robinson this past weekend out in Los Angeles at Cauliflower Alley. He said Regal is the greatest looking prospect since he came out of England himself. And I would have to agree with him, Regal is.
Well, Lars Steven Regal's got an attitude problem as far as I'm concerned. He's a great athlete, tremendous world television champion, talks bad about America. I don't like that. Talks bad sometimes about my colleague, Larry Zbysko. Sooner or later, he's going to get his upcoming. This thing isn't over by no means, but Brad Armstrong really now has to get up off that mat, draw down and get some of that Armstrong and Kestrel fortitude, and fire back. If he doesn't fire back, Lars Steven Regal will remain world television champion.
I would certainly have to agree with that. And right now, Armstrong is back on his feet, but again, taking even more punishment on that left arm and left wrist, and a blow into the deltoid area. And Lars Steven Regal continued to try and dominate this entire situation. The World Television Championship at stake. As great a tactician is in the ring as Regal, and he was just upended by Brad Armstrong. But Armstrong has been weakened enough. They couldn't close in and take advantage of that situation.
Yeah, he's got to stay aggressive. He's got to be on top of Regal here. He's starting to go, but he's got to maintain this. Again, he can't rush. He can't get frustrated. Cannot make a mistake against Regal.
High hip toss by Brad Armstrong. Lateral press. But not enough strength, not enough weight to bear on that one. And now Regal with those bolo-like forearms. Nice move by Brad Armstrong, trying to get Regal into a backslide.
He's dropped. Armstrong has the leverage here.
He's got him in the backslide. One, two. No, sir, he got him.
And so did Lord Regal.
The heartbeat away from the title.
And I think he's going over to Sir William. They're checking on the time. Again, the time is in the favor of his lordship.
Certainly no question about that. By the way, as great a mat technician is as Steven Regal, tonight you'll see two that go the opposite direction. Tonight on WCW Saturday Night Live, we will be seeing the Nasty Boys in action.
I tell you, not a pretty sight, but they are an effective tag team.
Right here now, Brad, he's starting to mount a little offense right here. He needs to get him up and get him in there. He needs to bring him over right here.
He's trying to get the leverage, but Regal's dropping his weight. Armstrong kind of got it.
Hung up in the ropes now, and let's see what transpires from this point on.
Well, you should break the hold of you with the referee. Give Lord Regal a chance to come undone from the ropes.
Well, Brad Armstrong just helped him to get undone. He planted that boot right in the abdominal wall. And now a double leg pickup by Brad Armstrong.
Let's see if we can get him over here into a Boston Crab. Any type of offense might work here.
He's got him, and he's cinching down on it. Lord Steven Regal has to be in intense pain at this point in time. And will he? No, look at Regal. What a fantastic move on Regal's part.
Nice reversal right here. Got the 1-2.
I think Armstrong thought he had it. Okay, he's outside the ring.
Again, look at Regal. I think he realizes how the time is ticking. He'll do anything to kill 10, 20 seconds. Uh-oh.
Belly-to-back suplex by Brad Armstrong and Lord Steven Regal. Lateral press now. And again, Regal powers out before the count. And Regal coming to his feet very, very slowly. Backing off and begging off, if you will.
See, but Armstrong.
Armstrong closing in.
He's got to be aggressive here. He can't give Regal any time to get, you know, his thoughts back, get his wind back.
Yeah, hit him with it. Don't hit him with it, baby.
goal. He went to, and Regal countered very nicely, caught him. He's grabbed those tights, but he got the three count. He
Ladies
got the
and
three
gentlemen,
count.
Here is your winner, the world television champion, Lord Steven Regal.
Well, the three of us will be back with some closing comments right after this. Questionable, but still a victory for Lord Steven Regal. No question about that. Now, tonight on WCW Wrestling on Saturday night, we're going to see Flying Brian and Sting take on Paul Orndorff and Paul Roma. And we're going to hear some more comments from Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, a factoid that's got the whole world talking right here on TBS. Hulk Hogan speaks, but you know, Ric Flair, he's caught in the middle of something here. Hogan and Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. You know, I've got some advice for all the little people, and that is keep it simple, stupid. Concentrate on one thing at a time.
Dusty, do you think Hogan's appearance is going to upset the flow of Ric Flair?
Well, you know, this thing is bouncing back like a rubber ball. You know, Hulk Hogan came on talking about his movie. Everybody talking about the great Hulk Hogan. Then he mentioned Ric Flair. Ric Flair want to talk about Hulk Hogan. Hulk Hogan want to talk about Ric Flair. Ricky Steamboat talking about Ric Flair. Ric Flair talking about Ricky Steamboat. Everybody talking about everything else. But Hulkster's going to come on tonight and possibly on Saturday night clear this thing up. Ric Flair needs to concentrate on Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. We're going to have a new champion at the Spring Stampede.
I have to agree with that thought, too. And don't forget, tomorrow night on Main Event, it will be the boss against the All-American Ron Simmons. Till next week, Gordon Solie on behalf of Larry Zbyszko and the American Dream Dusty Rhodes saying so long.